successful casino resorts won the bid for the shuttered Revel. The question now is, what's to come for Atlantic City? Well, one of our Twitter users even went so far as to write, crazy watching Boardwalk Empire and seeing the rise of Atlantic City. Now I'm witnessing the city before my eyes shut down. So many memories. Are Atlantic City's best days behind us? Where does America's playground go from here? Joining us via Skype right now to talk all about this, entertainment columnist and Atlantic City expert, Whitney Allman. Good morning, Whitney. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
What do you think's going to happen? It's been a hard year. Four casinos closing. We had about 8,000 people lose their jobs. What are you thinking now?
Oh, gosh. You know what? Sometimes change is going to happen, and it comes down to just supply and demand. There was just too much supply, not enough demand. And of course, anytime change happens, people don't like it. And for me personally, it's sad because I live here. I live near the people who got laid off and who aren't working right now. Nobody wants to be in that position. But if you look at Atlantic City right now, it's not doom and gloom. There's so much going on. If you look at all the concerts we had in the summertime when people thought, oh, Atlantic City's shutting down, we weren't. We had over 65,000 people at both Blake Shelton and Lady Antebellum each. We had the Due AC Wine Promenade last week. Thousands of people came out for that. People are coming to Atlantic City. Revel just got bought by a company that runs casinos. They know what they're doing. It's just a great addition to the town. You could go anywhere. You could eat. You could go to the Tun Tavern and have some great beer and food. You could go to the Perfectly Innocent Amusement Company that just opened. You can go to Wingcraft. You could take your kids to Steel Pier. There's so much to do in Atlantic City.
Well, of course, that's the motto. Do AC. They had a great campaign. Right. And we know that there's a lot to do, but it's just not getting the people down there. The problem is we're losing a lot of these gamblers, certainly to Pennsylvania and also up to New York. So what do we do to attract those numbers back? Because we're just hemorrhaging people that used to go there. We're just not seeing those kind of numbers.
Well, we are going to be seeing a lot more numbers, and we do see numbers in Atlantic City right now. I mean, the entertainment is phenomenal. We have Usher coming into town. This weekend alone, we have so many people. We have Alanis Morissette. We have Foreigner. I'm interviewing Jesse McCartney at the Pool After Dark tomorrow night. So there is entertainment in Atlantic City. And don't forget, we have the beaches, and we have the boardwalk, and we have shopping. We're a very diverse destination for people to come to. It's not just going to another casino. What can you do in a Philadelphia casino for a comp? You come to Atlantic City and get comped, you can have a meal in a fabulous restaurant. You can walk the boardwalk. You can go shopping. There's a lot to do. You know, you have to just come to Atlantic City to see it. And if you were here on the weekends and even during the week when there's special events going on, you'll see that the city is packed. There are a lot of people there.
Well, Whitney, we know we love your enthusiasm, certainly for the city. You live there. It's sort of the Chamber of Commerce. You're very bullish on it. We certainly hope that its star is not dimmed completely, and we're certainly going to have a bright future. No. Whitney, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate it.